Hello everyone, welcome you all to Heat Power Engineering online class. So now let's discuss about unit 2, which is laws of perfect gas. So after discussing the whole unit, so the outcome, course outcome, which is understand different laws and equations related to perfect gas to find the solutions to related problems. Is it okay? So now let us move to the session number 10. So under this session, the contents we are going to deal with. So number one, definition of perfect gas. The next one is gas laws. What are the different types of gas laws? So those are Boyle's law, Charles' law, Gay-Lussac law, and we are discussing with Joule's law. Finally, the Avogadro's law. Okay. So now let us see one by one. The first one is an introduction part. Let us see what is a perfect gas and how we can call out gas as a perfect gas. So perfect gas, in fact, it is also referred as ideal gas. Okay, an ideal gas is defined as a state of a substance whose evaporation from liquid state is complete and strictly obeys all the gas laws under all condition of temperature and pressure. This is very important. The condition is that the gas should obey all the gas laws under the entire condition of temperature and pressure. Okay, so this is what the basic definition for perfect gas. Yes, an ideal gas is also referred as a perfect gas. So now say there are differences between ideal gas and real gas. You might have heard this word, that is real gas. What is the difference between this ideal gas and real gas? See, normally we can say ideal gas and real gas, which has a major difference. In between, the major difference is that ideal gas will obey the gas laws in the entire conditions of temperature and pressure. But in case of real gas, which will never obey the gas laws under the entire condition of temperature and pressure. So this is a major difference. But in sometimes, you know, the real gases under low pressure and high temperature. So this is a particular condition where the real gas which will obey the laws of gases. So you can say that in that condition, the real gas will become a ideal gas. Okay. And next difference, you can say an ideal gas, the volume of the molecules of that gas, a gas which has its own molecules, okay, the volume of the molecules which is negligible. In case of ideal gas, the volume of molecules, I'm not talking about volume of gas, volume of molecules which is very less, you can say it is negligible, but the volume of molecules of a real gas, which is not negligible, which has a certain amount. So this is the second major difference between ideal gas and real gas. Is that okay? Yes, fine. Now let us move to the next one, that is the variables of ideal gas. So there are totally four variables for any ideal gas. The variables are, you can say, temperature, pressure, volume, and finally moles. You can say that the amount. That is moles. Okay. So now the next slide will be gas laws. What is gas laws? See, the behavior of an ideal gas is governed by different gas laws. The behavior of an ideal gas is governed by different gas laws, such as Boyle's law, Charles' law. So very importantly, Gay-Lussac law. So these are all the three very important gas laws which we are going to discuss, and along with this we also deal with Joule's law and Avogadro's law. So basically, what is this gas laws? So I will try to clarify with very simple the thing. See, the gas law is nothing but, already in the previous slide we have seen that there are four variables for a gas. The physical property of the gas can be observed or can be identified by these four variables. So the four variables are temperature, pressure, volume and moles. So what does the gas law means? See, we have tried to find the relation between any two variables, the difference relation between any two variables when rest of the two variables are constant. Is that okay? Gas law is nothing but we are trying to find the relation between any two variables when other two variables are kept constant. So this is nothing but gas law. Simple. Okay. So now let us see one by one the gas law. First of all, let's see Boyle's law. What is this Boyle's law? Boyle's law, Boyle is a scientist, you should remember this. Boyle's law states that during a change of state, you can say from state 1 to state 2, the volume of the given mass of gas, given mass means the mass is fixed. So mole, N, which is fixed, you can say it is constant. Okay, during a change of state, the volume of a given mass of gas varies inversely with the absolute pressure. When temperature remaining constant. See, number of moles constant because it is a given mass of a gas. Temperature is also constant. So two variables are constant. So rest of the two are pressure and volume. Of course, see, we are finding the relation between volume and pressure. So according to the Boyle's law, what happens? During the change of state, the volume of the gas inversely proportional or inversely varies with its absolute temperature. What do you mean by inversely? Inversely means, yes, when volume increase, pressure decrease. Or you can say when pressure increase, volume decrease. Yes, that is the meaning of inversely. If you can say, to write mathematically, P is pressure of the gas, it is a notation, and V is equal to volume of the gas. So according to the Boyle's law, you can write V is proportional to 1 by P. Is that right? What do you mean by V is proportional to 1 by P? 1 by P means when volume increases, pressure decrease, inversely proportional. Yeah. The condition is that P is constant. As well as you should remember, N is also constant. Yes. Or you can simplify this and you can write PV is equal to constant. How come it is? How comes? PV is equal to constant. How it? See, it is possible you can resolve these equations. The equation is V is proportional to 1 by P. Is that right? Yes. Now you can rewrite this equation as V is equal to C by P. V is equal to C by P. What is C? C is nothing but constant. When you are adding a constant, this proportional turns into equal. So V is equal to C by P. C is nothing but a constant. So if you cross multiply the equation, what happens? PV that is equal to C. Instead of 1, you can write here, it is C. Only when if you write C, it will become equal. So PV is equal to constant, and should you remember, the condition is temperature T is constant and number of moles are also constant. So this is what Boyle's law is. Okay. So now see, this is an attachment. By using this attachment, you can say that an animation. By referring this animation, you can try to clarify the Boyle's law practically. See, here you have an attachment. You can see a cylinder. So where you have a mass input here and it is fixed. Fixed in the sense, we are not adding any amount of the gas. So inside the cylinder, you can see that cursor point clearly. Inside the cylinder, there is a certain amount of gas which is already inserted inside the cylinder and which is fixed. So during the process, we are not entertaining any amount of gas. So what is the meaning of this? What I'm trying to say? Yeah, mass of the gas is constant. It is nothing but number of moles. Moles is nothing but over this yellow color, can you see that black dots? Yes, that is called as number of moles. The number of moles is constant. because you're not adding any amount of gas. That is the first understanding, that is N is constant. And next one, you can see two gauges here. Can you see two gauges? Yes, the one gauge represents pressure and one more gauge will give temperature. And if you clearly observe this, the temperature gauge is unmoved. Temperature gauge is unmoved. What is the meaning? Yes, temperature is constant. And you can see this flame also. Okay, is it blinking? Is there any movement for this flame? No, right? So this is in a neutral position. Meaning is? Yeah, temperature is constant. And now see this attachment. Inside the cylinder you have a piston. You have a piston. Okay, this green color represents when this piston is moving upwards, the pressure is very less. When the piston is moving downwards, see, this is applying load. You are applying the load. So there is a reason why you can observe there are plenty of green color. Green color waves. You can see? Yeah, this is that. You can observe this. Okay. And you know, some observations, one more observation is, whenever this piston, the red color piston, when it moves upwards, the cylinder volume is going to increase. Yes. Also, when piston moves downwards, the volume inside the cylinder is going to decrease. That is a clear cut observation. So inside the cylinder, there is a gas. When the piston is moving downwards from, you can say that
at the top dead center to bottom dead center, what happens? Piston moves downwards. Is compressing the gas. The piston compressing the gas. The compressing means what? Volume is going to decrease. So when it is moving, when the piston is moving downwards, you can observe this pressure gauge. What happens? Yes, pressure gauge is showing the pressure is increasing. Pressure is increasing till it reach 2 bars. Till it reach 2 bars. So when volume decrease, piston is moving downwards means what? Volume decreasing, pressure is going to increase. Similarly, vice versa, when piston moving upwards, you can see the pressure gauge again. The pressure decreasing. The pressure is going to decreasing. So it is nothing but when volume increase, pressure decrease. So vice versa. So that you can conclude during the change of state, the volume of the gas varies inversely with the absolute pressure only when the temperature remains constant. There will be a graphical representation. You can also measure or you can also cross-check this graphical representation along with the movement of piston. I hope this is clear about Boyle's law. Is that okay? Yes. So now let's move. Boyle's law continued. Hence, if you can say, now you can take based on the states. Okay. P1 is equal to initial pressure of given mass of gas. V1 is equal to initial volume of the gas. Similarly, P2 is equal to final pressure of the gas and V2 is equal to final volume of the gas. Yes. Now, we know that PV is equal to constant, right? PV is equal to constant. So that equation you can rewrite in the form of states. That you can write instead of PV is equal to C, you can write P1 V1 that is equal to C and P2 V2 that is equal to C. Is that okay? Yes. So now you can also write this equation as in a general form P1 V1 that is equal to P2 V2 because it is equal to a common constant, right? P1 V1 that is equal to P2 V2 that is equal to, you can add a number of states. N number of states you can say. So that is equal to PN VN where N 1 2 etc. What it shows? Yes, number of states. So that is equal to C. C is nothing but a constant. C is nothing but a constant. So where 1 2 etc. refers to different sets of conditions. Is that okay? Hope so. Boyle's law is very clear now. Okay. So now let's move to the next slide, which is Charles' law. What is this Charles' law? It states that the volume of the gas, in fact, it is the given mass of the gas.
the volume of given mass of gas. What do you mean by given mass of gas? Can you answer? Yes, given mass of the gas means the number of moles are fixed, varies linearly. Which one? The volume of the gas varies linearly with the temperature. So there is a relation between two variables. What are those? Volume and temperature. In the previous case it was volume and pressure. Now the volume of the gas varies linearly with the temperature when pressure of the gas is maintained constant. So the pressure is constant. The pressure is constant. Given mass of a gas, N is constant. Of course, two variables are constant. So now we are trying to find out the relation between other two, which is volume and temperature. So according to the Charles law, it says that volume is directly proportional to the temperature when the pressure is constant. Okay? Mathematically, you can say V is proportional to T. What is the meaning of proportional to T? Yes, practically it is when volume increases, temperature is also going to increase. When volume decreases, temperature is also decrease. Okay? The condition when P is for pressure, that is constant. Or you can rewrite this equation as, say this is V is proportional to T. So you can make it equal, V is equal. How you can make? Yes, by adding a constant. V is equal to Ct, where C is the constant. Yes, V is equal to Ct, and you can rearrange this equation and you can rewrite as V by T, that is equal to constant. Or if you cross multiply this, it will become V is equal to Tc. Is that okay? V is equal to Tc, or you can simplify V is proportional to T. Yes. Now, V by T, that is equal to constant. In general form, the different states, you can write this Charles law as, instead of V by T, you can add some states, that is 1, 2, etc. till n states. I can write V1 by T1, that is equal to V2 by T2, that is equal to so on till n number of states. I can write Vn by Tn, that is equal to C, where C is a constant. So where 1, 2, etc. refers to different sets of conditions. Is it okay? Yes. Now let us see one animation for here also. See, again this is a Charles law, the same animation. So here again you can see this is a mass. So where you can insert the ideal or the gas into the cylinder, but it is unmoved. What is the meaning? Yes, we are not adding any amount of the gas into the system when which is undergoing a process. Okay, so now you can see the yellow color, which is gas, it represents gas, and inside that there are a black holes. So it is nothing but number of moles. So it is constant there. So n is equal to constant. Again, same. There are two gauges. One represents pressure, and one more for a temperature. And here the pressure gauge is unmoved. What is the meaning? Yeah, pressure is constant, and you can see this is a flame. Is there any fluctuation in this flame? Yes, the intensity is going increasing as well as decreasing. So increasing intensity means what? You are increasing the temperature. Is that okay? See, the temperature is going to be increasing. So whenever the temperature is increasing, what happens? The piston is moving upward. Piston is moving upward. Piston is moving upward means what? You're increasing the volume. So what Charles law says then? Charles law says, the volume of the gas varies linearly with the temperature. When volume increases, temperature is also increased. Or when temperature increases, volume is also increased only when pressure maintained as constant. See, when temperature decreases, volume is also going to reduce. Is that okay? And you can also compare with this VT diagram, or we can say that a graphical representation. Is that okay? Yes, hope so. It is clear. So now, this is the third gas equation, Gay-Lussac law. Let us see what is this law. It states that the absolute pressure of a given mass, again, given mass of a perfect gas. What do you mean by given mass of a perfect gas? N is constant. So then the absolute pressure of a gas varies directly as its absolute temperature. So pressure is proportional to temperature when the volume remains constant. See, volume is constant, number of moles is also constant. Again, we are finding the relation between two variables, which are pressure and temperature. So, according to the Gay-Lussac law, you can write P is proportional to T when volume is constant. Don't forget number of moles also. Yes, constant. So, now P is proportional to T. I can simplify this equation. P is equal to Ct. I have added one constant here and thereby I rearranged this equation as P is equal to Ct, where C is equal to constant. Or you can write, you can take this T into a left hand side. What happens? P by T is equal to C, where C is a constant. Yes. So in general, again, for different states, I can rewrite this equation in the form of states. I can write as P1 by T1, that is equal to P2 by T2, that is equal to, for n number of states, P and by Tn, that is equal to constant. Okay? So this is what? Gay-Lussac law. Okay? Fine. So there are all the important parts in this law. Now let us move on to the next session, next slide, which is Joule's law. So sometimes you may say that it is Joule's law. Okay, so Joule's law, Joule's law. So Joule's law states that the change of internal energy, you know what is the meaning of energy, what is the meaning of internal energy. Okay, I hope you know this. The change of internal energy of a perfect gas is directly proportional to the change of temperature. It is nothing but when temperature changes, internal energy of the gas is also going to change. Okay? So mathematically, I can write this equation, I mean this law, as dE, where E is the notation for internal energy and d for difference. D for difference. Difference means change, because law says that the change of internal energy of a perfect gas is directly proportional to the change of temperature, so that dE is proportional to dT. Again, T is the temperature here and d is the difference, or you can say that the change. Yes, so I can write this equation. dE is equal to, for a given mass, that is m, into cc is a constant here again, and dt. So this is equal to mc, instead of dt, difference, I can write it as final temperature T2 minus initial temperature T1. Initial temperature T1. So where m is equal to mass of the gas, c is equal to a constant, is known as specific heat. An important consequence of this law is that, remember, the temperature of a given mass m of a gas changes from T1 to T2. When the temperature of a given mass of a gas changes from T1 to T2, then the internal energy will change from E1 to E2. This is what the law says. As in temperature changes, internal energy is also going to change. Okay? And the change in internal energy is nothing but E2 minus E1. E2 minus E1. Final minus initial will be same irrespective of the manner of how the pressure and volume. Is that okay? Yes. Yeah. This is the equation MC into T2 minus T1. So now the last law we are going to discuss here, it is Avogadro's law. So what is this Avogadro's law? Avogadro's law states that equal volumes of all perfect gas under the same condition of temperature and pressure. Temperature and pressure is constant now. Okay? Equal volume of the perfect gas under the same condition of temperature and pressure contain equal number of moles. When volume increase, mole is also going to increase under the same condition of temperature and pressure, this is what the Avogadro's law states. So here the constants are two variables, which are temperature and pressure. These two variables are constant. Volume and moles are not constant, which are the variable, and we are trying to find the relation between these two variables, which are volume and number of moles. So the equal volume of all perfect gases under the same condition of temperature and pressure contain equal number of moles. So mathematically I can write V is proportional to N, where N is equal to number of moles. So V, of course, you know that is volume. Or you can say, you can add a constant. You can add a constant as C or K. In some textbook you can refer to C, and in some textbook you can see K. So there is nothing difference, where C, K, whatever, which is constant. Constant is constant. So V is equal to K N, where K is a constant. If you add C, doesn't matter. Okay. So again, you can rewrite this equation, V by N, that is equal to K, or you can write that is equal to C. So in general, for different states, for state 1, 2, etc., you can rewrite this equation as V1 by N1 is equal to V2 by N2, so on, Vn by Nn, that is equal to what? Yes, that is equal to constant. So this is what? Avogadro's law. So where V1 is equal to initial volume, N1 is equal to initial quantity of gas moles, V2 is equal to final volume, and N2 is equal to final quantity of gas in moles. Okay. So now, let us see a small puzzle here. Just to give a work for your mind to solve or to understand this Avogadro's law. So please concentrate on this puzzle. I'll explain what is it. See, you can see three balloons here, right? Of different colors, I can say. One is green, one is red, and one is blue. Yeah. So there are some data he has given. In first balloon, of course, in all these three balloons, it contains gas in it. So in first balloon, the quantity of gas in moles. So there are 2 moles. So N is equal to 2 here. But we don't know the volume in liters. Liter means what? Yes, the all volume. We don't know the volume. N is known, but V is unknown. So come to the second balloon, which is red color. Number of moles, how much? Yes, 3 moles. And volume is 30. So N by V. So you can say this is N1 V1. Here it is N2 V2. Here is equal to N3 V3. So now in this third balloon, you don't know the value of N3 and you know the value of V3. Can you find out the value of V1 and N3? Yes or no? Yes, it is very easy. First, what you have to do is, you have to make a relation between these two balloons. Likewise, V1 by N1 is equal to V2 by N2. So you know the value of N1, you don't know the value of V1. Here you know the value of V2 and N2. You can solve this. The only unknown data is V1. Of course, easily you can solve the equation. So I think this is 20 liters, and here it is 4.5 moles, because 3 moles for 30 liters, right? Yeah, so this is how you can solve Avogadro's law. So thank you very much, students.